going to take you to Belize in Central America.
All praises due.
Greetings, how are you today? I'm Zaza, Zaza International. I'm here today in Cancun, Mexico. Welcome to Cancun. I'm here today on a fact-finding mission. I'm going to take you to Belize in Central America. All you need is your passport. We're going to listen to Herb Alpert and the Tijuana Brass on the way in this beautiful coach. So come right on along. Enjoy yourself. Peace.
I first heard about Belize from a beautiful young lady at the airport in Atlanta, Jackson Parkfield Airport. I saw a beautiful young lady walking down Concourse A, and she was walking in such a peaceful, slow, heavenly stride. I hadn't seen anyone walk like that before. I went to her and I asked her where she was from, and she told me she was from Belize. And I hadn't heard of Belize. This was approximately 10 years ago. And I said, Belize? Where is Belize? And she said, in Central America. I said, tell me about Belize. And she told me so many different things about Belize. I just wanted to go there. And throughout the course of the years, every time I heard the word Belize, it would just make me want to be there, to go there, to see this paradise. And in 2012, that's exactly what I did. I went to Belize. I wanted to go to Belize to see if it was, first of all, was it really true, all the things that I had heard about Belize. And I wanted to see if it was possible for me to relocate myself and possibly my family, friends, and loved ones. I wanted to know what type of place it was. What type of people live there? Do these people really speak English? Do these people really look like me? What type of lifestyle do they have? What type of food do they eat? I was very interested in everything about these people. What type of clothes do they wear? How do they worship? I wanted to know. I met a young, beautiful sister named Carla. Sat down and I talked to her. We went to the park and she gave us so much beautiful information about Belize. And she told us about all the different areas in Belize. So, all the things that she told me, I really wanted to participate in. She told me about Hummingbird Highway, Hummingbird Mountains. She told me she lived in Hopkins. I wanted to be in Hopkins. I wanted to drive down the Hummingbird Highway. I wanted to be in the Hummingbird Mountains. I wanted to do all the things that she had mentioned. Barbara Mobley invited us to her home for a celebration of Belize, a celebration of going to Belize, going to the Chocolate Fest in Punta Gorda. The name has even excited me. Punta Gorda, what a name. And she had a video in her home. It showed us all about that area.
Greetings! Belize it or not,
we're in Belize, Central America. We're going to introduce you to quite a few beautiful people. Some of these people look just like you and I. You're going to be able to meet these people on this fact-finding tour in our second half of this program. Stay tuned!
It shows us all about Belize. It shows us all about Dangriga. It shows us all about Hopkins. It showed us all about all the different areas in Belize that sounded so unbelievable. It sounded so tropical. It sounded like paradise. It sounded like Mother Nature's cup that Mother Nature would drink out of. I just wanted to be there. I wasn't able to go with the tour because the tour was only going to be there for a short time. And I knew all the things that I wanted to do would take a much longer period of time. So I made plans to do just that, to go to Belize, and I was able to be there for 3 weeks. I attempted to make reservations with Delta Airlines and fly to Belize from Atlanta, Georgia. But I was on a budget, and I didn't want to spend all of my money on transportation, just flying to Belize. And I knew that once I was on the plane, what would happen when I got up there, I wouldn't see much more than clouds. And I wanted to see this hemisphere that I hadn't seen. I wanted to see the earth. I wanted to see the scenery. I wanted to be involved with the climate. I wanted to see this. I wanted to smell this part of the earth. And I wanted to not use all my money, give all my money to Delta Airlines. So I had to make other plans. I called my brother, Balewa, in Punta Gorda, and I asked him other ways of travel. And that's when I was told, well, you can also fly to Cancun, Mexico, and then take a bus to Belize. I had known that he had had troubles trying to go through Mexico alone. He wasn't permitted to cross the border into Mexico. I knew that I couldn't drive. So I said, this sounds like something that I can do. And that's exactly what I did. I was very, very interested in the agriculinary aspects of the country, being the agriculinary ambassador. I was so very interested in this. I really didn't know what types of fruits and vegetables they grew, and I wanted to see this for myself. We were able to go to the marketplace. We were able to go out into different farmlands and different villages, marketplaces.
Bored to death watching the television? Oh, and it's sweet, huh? Mm. New baby chicken.
That's the Mennonite chicken.
The new baby bananas, pineapple. They have chocolate there. But I wanted to see this for myself. And that's exactly what I did.
My dear brother, it's so good to see you. My brother from Seven Islands, and this is not a commercial. Now tell us one more time how to say your name properly.
Musin.
Musin. Bored to death watching the television?
Stay tuned to WACPtv at the fact-finding journey to Central America with Ambassador Zaza continues. Believe it or not.
You're just going to have to tell me who I'm speaking with.
Oh, well, I'm Gomie. I have a restaurant at the Y, I call it, which is in Punta Gorda.
And I've been here since 1997, trying to promote a healthy lifestyle. It's an alternative to what the other restaurants are doing here. And then now we're facing the ocean, enjoying that nice sea breeze.
Now
coming from
you
the ocean.
Have quite a view here for a restaurant. Look at this. Now, is that the Caribbean?
That's the Caribbean, yes.
Oh, this is just beautiful. Now, this is your sign. What's the name of your business?
Gummy's Restaurant. We do vegetarian and seafood.
Vegetarian and seafood.
And then, like you can see, you know, like there's an old saying that we are made out of what we eat.
Yeah.
My sign represents your health. It's your wealth. That's the greatest thing you can achieve. Food is man's best and greatest medicine.
Looks like a banana plant right out in front of your restaurant.
Yeah.
Okay, now did you plant that?
I did plant it, yeah.
Now, what form was this when you planted it?
It was just a little sucker. You know, just a piece of banana that way, and then I stick it in the ground. Now we've got leaves growing.
Okay.
I surrounded myself around people involved with agriculinary.
Do like a nice little.
Okay, now.
Yeah.
Your name is Billy?
Yes, Bam. And I'm the automotive technician.
Okay.
So I was supposed to meet Barbara, I guess, when she comes back.
Well, she probably give her another day or two, and she'll probably be here talking to you.
Yep.
What made you come back?
Brought back the technology back home.
Oh, okay. All right. Throw yourself on your motorbike.
Yeah, I'm going to pick up the wife.
All righty.
So, I'll see you guys later.
Good talking to you.
All right, take care.
Bye-bye. Okay. Are you enjoying yourself?
Oh, yes. I'm having a blast.
I think you're living in paradise. Living in paradise. You know anything about the land mass here, real estate or anything?
Yes, I tell you some. I took my friend. I got some land right here. So when she comes, she'll be back.
Well, you share all that information. You enjoy your ride. Now this is a mighty beautiful muffin.
Yeah.
Tell me about this muffin.
Yeah. Well, it's a vegetarian or vegan muffin. I was born in St. Lucia, but I've been living in Belize for quite a long time. And it was something that I was really interested in. So when I came to Belize, I wanted to introduce healthy cooking and healthy lifestyle.
Well, you most definitely are doing just that. All right, thank you so much.
You're welcome, thank
peace,
you.
Peace and love.
Yes, thank you also.
Delicious.
Very beautiful.
This is beautiful.
He inspired me for that because the most Moroccan people come in, so.
Yes.
Now, who's the artist of this work?
Well, I made this man, you know. I get the inspiration and vibration way back from Africa, you know. I just think about Africa, make black arts, you know.
Yes.
Because everyone making different arts, and I be able to see black arts, and I different black arts.
Now, who am I speaking with?
I'm Henry III.
Henry III.
A musician from the south of Belize, Punta Gorda town, Toledo.
You do keyboards, don't you?
Yeah, I do my keyboards. I play keyboard. I teach music. I play guitar.
This is beautiful.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
these canes.
This is my cane that the brother say some friends are going to come up.
Yes.
So I prepare some canes, hurriedly.
And any of this for sale?
Oh, yeah. Anyone is on the market, and then you can make an order.
Oh, look at this picture.
Yes. Okay.
Beautiful. That's a beautiful picture. We are creative people.
Very, very creative. My roots from Nigeria.
Oh.
I dug out my roots from Nigeria.
Oh, right.
Nigerian people. They have the, everyone serve up for God, you know. And so if you humble yourself to the God, the God will give us the spirit. Mm. Because many of us got art in us, but we don't have the spirit of the God to take it out.
Right. Yes.
Yeah. Many things stops us. Sometimes the tools. Sometimes, many times, it's the urge and the spirit.
Yes.
That stops us.
Oh.
That's.
All right.
This is organically grown watermelon right here in Belize. You see the seeds in them? They have seeds. All right.
Oh, that was a wonderful experience driving down the road in Big Creek going to Merrill's and Allen's farm. It was a long, winding, dusty road, farmland all around us, trees of fruits growing all around us, and we were going very fast. I was in the car with Cardinal Hodari and my dear brother Emmett, and the Lewa was driving his truck, and we were following him. Have you ever heard the saying, "Now eat my dust"? That's what we did. God said, raise the window, because I'll tell you, those roads were dusty and we were moving fast. And it was a fun ride. It was a real adventure going around those curves. And then another car came in the other direction heading toward us. And it was only a road for one-way traffic. We had to pull over and slow down and allow that other car to get past. But it was real exciting. It was beautiful. It was quite an adventure just getting up there to their farmland.
You look good. Yes, you look good. Yes, what's your name?
Bob.
What?
Bob.
Bob? Bob Marley?
Yeah.
Okay, I like it. Look at the beautiful chickens. Oh, wow. Pretty, pretty. Oh, you're beautiful.
People have been getting up in the morning and climbing trees and going to have their oranges and their orange juices and their limes and their grapefruit. It was just amazing to me to see all the different types of fruits and vegetables. We were able to see fruits that I had never seen. I had a cherry that was so beautiful and red and sweet. I had never seen that type of cherry before. I had a banana that was so small and so sweet. It tasted like a candy bar.
So you're from Atlanta too?
Yeah. You been to Atlanta?
No.
Oh, you're in the right place. Oh, okay.
But never really been to Atlanta.
Well, you're in paradise. What's your name one more time?
Emmett Young.
Emmett Young.
Yeah.
Now what do you do, Emmett?
I'm a drummer.
When am I going to hear you?
In a little bit.
Today?
Yeah.
Wonderful! Have you ever heard of a man named Bob Marley?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I just want to know. Yeah. Do you play a reggae or what type of music?
I play traditional West African music.
Okay.
Mali and Guinea. I play the djembe. And I also play traditional rhythm of Belize from the Creole and the Garifuna people.
Can't wait to hear it.
Yeah.
Now, what area were you born in?
I was born in a little village called Gales Point, Manatee.
Now, where is that?
That is in the center of the country.
Oh, look at the eggs.
Hey, I don't know what she's doing with the maids.
Now, how many eggs do you collect a day out here? This is so wonderful. You all are just so blessed. Oh, the little baby chickens. Oh, ooh, you a big one too. Is this the only turkey you have? Now we just talking. I know we just met last night, but you're gonna have to tell me again. Who am I talking to?
This is Alan.
Alan, calling?
Yeah.
My name is Zaza, Ambassador Zaza, being sent to Belize to learn about the agriculture that's going on here. Tell me who you are and tell me what's going on out here on this beautiful land.
Well, I'm from New Orleans.
Yes.
And the forces of Babylon destroyed our city.
That's right.
So now we're looking to spread out and bring the Spirit of God everywhere. Since they destroyed us and drove us out of New Orleans.
Yes, they did.
So the Most High gave me this form. And with
the Most High gave you this form?
Yeah, he gave me. Because see, you can't buy nothing like this.
Yeah.
I paid for it.
Oh.
You see all the orange trees that was all here?
Yes.
All these trees was here when I got here.
Well, how many years have you been here?
I've been here for about 5 years.
5 years.
Yeah.
And you got a good price.
Yeah. They taught everybody, especially our people, division.
Tell me about coming out of Babylon, what you have to do.
Well, when I first met Merle, and it's taken us about 5 years for us to come together,
uh-huh.
to be able to work together.
Yes.
Because we live in a worldwide system where division is sown very deep, and it's so insidious that people don't even know they divided against themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So in order for us to work together, we have to learn how to love each other.
That's right.
You see? Because traditionally, the whole world hates us without
mm-hmm.
a cause.
Mm-hmm.
Because God has put His Spirit in us and has chosen us.
Yes.
So we're hated without a cause.
Yes.
So once we understand that, then we can begin to love each other. And mm-hmm. then we can work together.
Mm-hmm.
See, we need people. We need to work together. For example, you can't do everything by yourself. So
uh-huh.
this is something that we can do cooperatively.
Yes.
And not only feed people here in Belize, but we can export this thing and feed our people in other countries.
You can feed the multitudes.
Exactly.
Okay.
That's our intention.
That's right.
You see? Because once we learn how to feed ourselves,
uh-huh.
then we can govern ourselves.
That's right. That's right.
Because nobody will bite the hand that feeds you.
That's right.
But we have to feed our own people.
Yes.
And Belize is a perfect place to do it because it's the most fertile place I have been.
Avocados. Do you have any avocado trees here?
Yeah. There's two of them. Right
well,
there.
Let's go look
now,
at these.
This
apples.
Is one of my favorite fruits, avocados. Now, you say this tree is about 3 years old.
It's about 3 years old.
Now, this is one of the foods that I would like to have an avocado orchard. Yes.
That is not hard.
Oh, really?
Yes. Once you put them in the ground, you're through with it. All you got to do is wait mm-hmm. for them to grow. You see?
No.
And I have about 6 avocado trees here.
Oh, you're blessed.
So you just fertilize those. They
uh-huh.
you need to.
It is said that the United States of America is one of the richest countries on the planet. You know what? When I got to Belize, those people there, they made me stop and they made me look to see what is really wealth. And I just have a different opinion about this thing that they call wealth. I think when you can get up on in the morning
right
and
there.
Go
yeah,
out
and
in nature
and
get your,
and you got your pumpkins
breakfast
up already.
Off of the trees, and you can get your dinner out of the soil. I think that's well.
Some music here. There's the music right there. All right. Now I know that this is not a habanero tree.
Yes, that is.
What?
Hey, wait.
That's Merle's tree.
I have never seen a habanero tree grow this big.
She's been nursing that tree for the last.
What?
I'm gonna get meat over there, man.
What?
Yeah. The same tree, man.
The same tree. Now that's beautiful.
See out here, man.
That, you know what? I bet those are some of the hottest peppers on the planet. Now, come on one more time. Tell the camera who we're talking to. Come on, beautiful sister.
Well, this is my pepper that I plant.
Oh.
It's hot habanero pepper.
Now, how old is that plant?
1 year.
1 year? Oh, they can grow that big in 1 year?
Yeah.
That's wonderful. Well, now, I'm looking at all these plates. These plates look good. You got rice, fish, and plantains.
Right.
Oh, wow. Oh, look at that. Now,
see, you can see what the... These are the small cacao trees.
That's where I'm starting them at.
Oh, okay.
And see, we can plant our own trees.
Yes.
I got the seeds.
Uh-huh.
You see...
Oh, that is, oh, you have a bunch of them down in there.
This is a Jamaican lime here. Juicy, real juicy lime.
Oh, yes.
This right here is a mahogany tree.
Where they get that mahogany wood?
Right, that's the mahogany wood.
And that's the cacao seed, too.
That's the cacao seed right there.
Oh, look at this.
See, that's the chocolate seed. That's where chocolate comes from. He's going to take you to the chocolate factory.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, you got
I can't
that.
Wait.
That's from them.
But it was beautiful. It was beautiful. What made it so pleasant, it was the way that I was treated. The brothers being so respectful of me. Alan and his beautiful queen to me. And most of all, tasting the food that Mira cooked for us.
It's a nice place to go, man.
She fixed fresh fish, and she fixed rice, but it didn't taste like any fish and rice that I had ever had. It had a completely different taste to it.
Oh, bravo.
I don't know what herbs she put in it. I don't know. I did taste a little garlic. I did see onions. I did see other vegetables that was in the fish and the rice. That was so good.
It's a nice place to go, man. Nice sweet rice.
Yeah. Now, first of all, have you named this tree?
No, I don't name this tree.
You don't name this tree?
I like this
up on the river. Oh, yeah.
This is the big, yes, see?
Oh, yes. That's the biggest habanero I believe I've seen. They are beautiful.
And these are florins.
Uh-huh. Now you already have habaneros on here, and you have some new ones coming already.
Yeah.
So you have habaneros all year round. Look at that. All year round. You are truly best. Now I want you to give the sisters in Atlanta a shout out and tell them about
it. Hi, you need to visit Belize. You guys are missing out the sweetness of Belize.
That's right.
WACPtv, the place to be.
I wasn't fond of Belize City. I was more attracted to being out in the country area. So once I was on the second bus, which was taking me to Punta Gorda, that was when I really fell in love with Belize.
Just returned from Belize. I had just met Mom and Jerry. We do the Empress Menin Conference in March every year.
Peace. Peace and blessings. We had a beautiful time in Belize, Central America. Pack your bags because we're heading right back down here again, but there's going to be one different. You're going to be with me. I need at least minimum adventurous, beautiful people to come with us, male and female. I've done all the fact-finding information. Now we're ready for the adventure, Belize it or not. Stay tuned for our video. Stay tuned. You're going to love it, and you're going to feel that you were there. We're going to Elmo Pan. We're going to Hopkins. We are going all over Belize. We're going to the rainforest. You will love it. Peace.